Well,
And we
hello.
got the wrong scene. Well,
Good evening.
good evening, everybody. We are back from Vegas. The regular season has ended. We've started the playoffs and we've got a guest. So let's get the stream fired up. Chad, thanks for joining us. How are you doing?
Good. I'm feeling pretty good about the Rangers first round matchup, so everything's pretty good. The Maple Leafs lost. It's a good day.
Don't let Mike hear you say
I
that.
know, Mike. Poor Mike. He must be suffering at the normal
If
Maple
he's a Maple
Leaf
Leafs fan, how could he expect anything different
feelings.
from the
Toronto
playoffs?
doing Toronto things, right?
Yes, Twitter has already gone crazy on that one. It's gone mental with
Was what,
hilarity.
5-1 final?
5-1 final. Last one was an empty netter,
Empty
but
net, yeah.
yes, Austin Matthews, obviously. All that 69 wore
Yeah.
him
Couldn't quite get over the edge to that 70, huh?
No. It's funny, isn't it? Because not that the Bruins did well last year in the first round either, but this time at least they're not going to get swept. So,
Well,
Well, they.
and Toronto last year, I think, lost one of the games in that one series that they've won in the last however many years. They lost one of those games 7-3, and yet still managed to win that series. So, I mean, it's the first game of a seven-game series, so.
Exactly. Seven game series. It is the eighth time in a row that the Bruins have beaten the Leafs, though. So momentum is on their side right now, I would suggest.
Yeah, but Winnipeg's beat us all season too, and I don't think momentum's going to have anything to do with that series.
It's a
You
tough
play
one,
playoffs is
though.
different.
It's a tough one, that
Especially
one.
if you live in Las Vegas, you get to take magic cures for what ails you.
Yeah, doesn't matter if you rupture a spleen.
Yeah, well, I mean, isn't it amazing? Scientists all over the world are indeed flocking to Vegas to study these players. Not only do they have remarkable healing powers, but they manage to do it exactly in the right date so they can pick the date that they're going to heal
Yeah.
completely. It's incredible. I mean, think of what hunger, medical problems solved. Everything can be solved by the Vegas Golden Knights.
Everything on Twitter that I've seen is just that announcement from the coach saying, yeah, he'll be good to go. He's full contact jersey and yeah, ready to play for Mark Stone.
This is the jerseys they'll be wearing.
Yes, most valuable player in the league.
LTIR.
There's your Hart Trophy winner. Or at least your Conn Smythe winner. So.
That'll be the one. So it's just hilarious. I guess one side effect is it has had a lot of people going to cheer on Dallas in that series, I guess. So I got to get back to the other screen here for you. There you go.
Yeah, I hope you guys put them down in the first round.
Well, I'm not as frightened about them as I might have been a while back, because it's even with these six players coming back or whatever. Well, Pietrangelo and Stone are back. I don't know. They might have had others. I'm still not super concerned. I think we can do it.
Yeah, I don't think you guys should have an issue. The decider between you guys may be Ottinger and Aiden Hill.
Yes, and I'm a little bit more confident about Ottinger after the last 10 games of the season when he went 8-8-1-1 or something. He was a
And
lot
Hill
better.
hasn't looked that great down the stretch.
No, he has
So
not. So
yeah, that could definitely be a factor in there. But let's say hi to chat too. We got Smokey and Z in here. We got Kremlon in here, and Davina Duckworth just came in. So good to see
yes.
all y'all. I know on my Rumble I've got it pinned for the bracket challenge we're gonna do. I can go in and pin it on my YouTube as well, the invite for that for anybody who wants to do that. And I think
Yeah.
Brian, you're gonna pin it on yours.
It's pinned on both my YouTube and Rumble. It's quite a simple link, and then there's a passcode to join the league. It's I thought let's pick an easy passcode, one that's easy to remember. So
Yeah. You're a trashy old man.
I am a trashy old man, yes. I'm feeling pretty trashy right now. Excuse my voice, but
Hey, Mike.
I've been suffering since we came back from Vegas. Woo-hoo! Vegas with I picked up some kind of throat thing, and it's raging up and down here, and coughing and spluttering, and not sleeping well. So forgive me if I sound a bit.
Well, at least you made sure Brahma had a great time.
Yeah, I should never have kissed X-ray girl.
That is one way to get sick every time. Sorry, you go to a meetup is hang out with X-ray girl.
Well, yeah, I did kiss Mark the Cyborg, it was X-ray girl. So.
And DiCarlo, Leafs suck.
Mike is here. Well, Mike, at least you've got your bracket submitted. It'll be interesting to see everyone's brackets. I don't think we can actually physically
until
see
until they lock, we will not be able to see anybody except for who's logged in. So once they're locked, we can see everybody's. Yes. But it's to make it to where somebody can't just copy somebody else's bracket.
But right now, and it is the NHL bracket challenge. You can create as many brackets as you want and assign that they can be assigned to any public league, but we've created a little private one. But you could, with that passcode I put out, you can assign that. Sign up for that. Well, Mike's already signed up. Smokey, Brahma.
There's Eclay.
I seem to be in there twice.
Yeah, and it was showing the same thing with me. The reason is, so when you're logged in, it shows your bracket at the top no matter what place you're in, but then it'll show you down below in the place that you're in. So that will disappear once we, well, it won't disappear. You'll be in whatever position you're in. So
I don't think it locks until all the first games are done.
Yeah, I think we still got 2 days for sign up. I think it locks either tomorrow night or Monday night.
So I would urge Davina, Kremlin, all everybody get Eclay. In there. Eclay, sign up. Get it. Get your brackets in. You can get more than one in if you want. I've got two brackets. I can't seem to assign the second one here, which is annoying.
But you have to designate which one is going to be your actual bracket for our league. We're not doing the everybody gets three or four brackets that are counting. You've got your good bracket that you're actually entering. Then you can screw around with some other ones just for fun. Right. But.
Well, this is my bracket. Hard to see. I know it's a little bit hard to see, but it's for some reason I thought I'm going to be a homer and I'm going to show some faith. Even though I don't think that's the outcome that's going to happen, and I'm going to put the Stars as the winners. So
and I'm doing the same thing.
Yeah, well, I think you've got more chance, but that's the second
point. You guys finished first, and you're favored by quite a few more teams, broadcasters and analysts. So
well, we'll see if we can get past the
no
LTIs.
False humility, Brian.
Yeah, humility. You know, we're not that good.
That hat is making my head way too red.
It does look red. It looks like a big angry tomato.
Yeah, it's from all that walking in Las Vegas.
I got a bit of a tan.
Stupid sun.
I spent the last day by the pool as well, trying to kill as many hours as I could before I had to go to the airport.
Right.
Because it was such a late flight. When I got to the airport, Disparu was there, so we hung out for an hour, which was fun.
Yeah, you were saying that.
Yeah, but well, then I got back home and I drove home through a blizzard, which was
nice. Yeah, we've been having the snow going on here today, on and off all day.
Oh,
so.
Shit.
Well, yeah. the other part of our show, of course, is bourbon. So you may be feeling under the weather and may not be having any, but I'm going to have some early times tonight.
Nice.
And we'll show off this, too. This came from you.
Oh, yeah.
In Vegas. Nice little Canadian whiskey. Full barrel number 3 char New American Oak from Park in Banff, Canada.
Nice.
So,
I've not even Park tasted Distillery. It myself.
Yeah, I'm... the father's going to be out next week. So we may crack it open and do a tasting together. And
that's what it's for.
See what we think of it.
Yeah, I did pick up a bottle in duty free on the way back, but I'm not going to have anything tonight because I'm not too well. So I'll skip it this week. But next week I will open a bottle and show it off. So.
What did you end up getting at duty free?
Oh, jeez.
Or do you not want to tell yet?
Basil Hayden, but red wine cask one. Okay. Basil Hayden. I do have a photograph of it. It's actually back there. Hang on, I'll go get it.
Yeah, it's not a big deal.
Give me a second.
Okay. Chad, you drinking anything tonight?
I am drinking sparkling ice fruit punch.
Gay.
Yeah, I don't drink. It all tastes like rubbing alcohol to me, so I just don't bother.
Yeah, when we get together, I'll teach you how to taste something other than the ethanol.
Yeah.
Cuz my wife says the same thing. She can't even smell whiskey or bourbon.
So I got this. It's possibly hard to see, but Basil Hayden,
the red wine cask finish.
Red wine cask. I know it's difficult to see, but looks pretty good. Neat bottle.
Yeah. Nice. They've got so many different bottles, it's hard to tell what's actually good with Basil Hayden. I mean, because they'll put out 100 different bottles in a year, and it's like, okay, which one is what? So, but I know quite a few people who like them. I've never gotten into them myself.
Yeah, this one appealed to me. The red wine cask finish one particularly appealed. So
I
looked for other stuff, and you'd recommended a few, but the duty free didn't have any of them. So,
which is strange.
The rest was just the ordinary stuff you would expect to get anywhere. So I got that.
Well, we got to have a whole bunch of Buffalo Trace in Vegas because I bought a 175 and a 750, and we managed to, between me, you, comics. Probably, I think Eric K had some. There were quite a few people. But I think I did the majority of it. But we downed two bottles of Buffalo Trace over that week. So, WG's coming in hot on your channel.
I saw that
$50 super chat.
I'm not sure I can.
Canes, baby. That.
Can I highlight that?
I already highlighted it. It's highlighted. It's on the screen at the moment.
It's on your screen.
Trust me, it's there.
Okay. Oh yeah, there it is. Yeah, thank you, WG. Of course, we hang out with WG. Met him in Vegas. Hang out a lot. Thank you, sir. Gave us gifts of Canes hats.
Canes hats.
And
which will sit behind me at some point because it's never touching this head, sir.
It's
but I do appreciate it.
Also, give me a very nice gift of a hat signed by Jason and Nick Robertson. So that was very good of you, sir. And $50 super chat is phenomenal. Thank you, my friend. I would like to play something for that. So let's see what I can find in the video front. Something nice, something sweet. You know what? We'll have a Bruins. Bruins were playing tonight, so let's have some Bruins.
Okay.
So here we go. It's on its way.
Hey, Bill. I don't know if that's a loud pistol.
It is. I might have to do something about the volume of this.
I guess Chara was in the suit.
Probably not the best two Bruins wins, but you know, it seemed worse. I think it's running a bit slowly.
Yeah, for some reason it's playing everything in slow motion for me.
Me too.
It was getting a little choppy.
Yeah.
Never mind. Let's transition out of that. Well, thank you, WG and Southern Bell. Yes, hello, Southern Bell. And Southern Bell, you should join the bracket because you don't have to pick players.
I just joined it, so we're
good.
Yeah, that's, don't have to pick players, just teams.
You can even Robin's going to be mad at me because I did pick the Stars to beat the Avs in the second round.
Southern Bell is a little bitch. Southern Bell has joined. So we have more brackets.
Cool. Well, how about we, I mean, this will probably get us in trouble, but how about we get into the mood for playoff hockey and check out the ad campaign that they did for playoffs.
Ah, springtime. Birds chirping, bees buzzing. It's a special time of year.
It's the Stanley Cup Playoffs!
Spring is everywhere.
Playoff hockey, nothing like it.
Well, if you feel the wanderlust, just grab a car.
We'll pause it every couple of seconds so Elvis doesn't get us killed.
Yeah.
A hop, a bus, in every town, there's excitement to be found.
The stage is set.
This crowd is charged up, a massive sense of anticipation.
The temperature is going up here.
Spring makes my feet alive.
We love you all! Let's show catching! McKinnon, Pasternak, Celtic!
I think that was McKinnon over Ottinger.
That never happened.
They really captured the way Ovechkin just sits there waiting.
Sits in his office. I still can't believe he got to 30 goals this year. He started off so freaking slow.
Well, there's going to be games you play against really crappy teams.
Especially in the East.
Didn't they make it with a negative goal differential?
Yeah, the worst goal differential in the history of the NHL for a playoff team. I believe it was minus 31 or minus 37. We'll have to look at the final standings. Because there are some weird quirks about this year's final standings.
Okay, I think
so that's TNT's.
That's TNT, you know, is it?
Get hyped.
I think the only Stars clip I saw was the one they were getting scored on.
The one where McKinnon shot.
Yeah,
I'm not
sure. There's not another Stars clip in there.
Oh, what a shame.
They showed a Rangers clip from 1994, so it's very timely.
Yeah, they showed a few teams doing their winning celebration.
So. Excuse me.
But yeah.
Sorry to interrupt, but I suppose we should be lucky that they didn't pick Viva Las Vegas as an Elvis song to play, because that would be the NHL's first choice, I expect.
Looks like that again, but I'm sure they'd be fine with the Rangers. You know, it's going to be interesting when we see the Rangers and Islanders possibly play, but the Islanders got
the Islanders aren't making out of the first round.
I don't think so either, but it would be great if we saw a battle of New York.
And I do have a couple of clips from that game.
They're already down 0-1 after tonight.
Yeah, I've got some clips from that. I got some of the goals from the Boston game too, if we're
there
interested.
Were a lot of goals in that Boston game because they were playing the Leafs.
But looking back on this season, this may have been the craziest regular NHL season we've seen in decades. I mean, between all the records broken, between it coming down to the very last game of the season to decide placements, all that kind of stuff. People like, you know, Austin Matthews getting the 69 goals, two players getting 100 assists within a day of each other.
Yeah.
McKinnon was one assist off of being only the fifth player in history to have 90 assists and 50 goals. I mean, this season was crazy. I mean, and then you look at the suspensions and everything else that happened throughout the year. This one was a special one to be watching. So I'm hoping that these playoffs follow suit, you know, from the regular season, because
the mark,
it's been insane this whole year. So
yeah, well, the talking of assists, the Avs had 295 assists on home ice alone.
Yeah, we had a good year on a home ice,
which and also that they had a charity thing going, so $295,000 were donated to Energy Outreach Colorado because of that. Here is one of those assists, I think, from the final game where you beat Edmonton.
16, that's
one
it.
Of the goals.
A car rocket is the mark. If they want to get Stuart Skinner 25 or 30 shots of work, shot it! Making it look easy.
16. It was kind of funny that they took out all their big boys and then left in their goalie to have him just get shellacked for the game.
Yes.
Also,
the confidence builder. Confidence.
Also, you did your screen share on the one without
Chad. Sorry, Chad. I cut you out of that one. Sorry. I need to get back to the screen share I was using.
Yeah, anyway, you used the fourth one down. Yep.
You try and do a nice thing by showing an Avs clip, and this is what happens. Try to be nice to you.
Well, it was... That was a weird game because we were still playing, kind of. I mean, we stopped in the third period. McKinnon probably could have gotten closer to the overall scoring lead because he came out in the first period and they were just peppering Skinner with shots.
Yeah.
And goals. McKinnon, I think, had 2 points in the first period, and they probably could have kept that up. But, I mean, yeah, Edmonton sat all their players, which is a weird decision because they could have locked up home ice through the first two rounds if they had won.
I did not get that at all. Didn't understand that at all.
Well, and speaking of other strange things that are happening, I mean, if we were to look at the standings, the final standings, Edmonton has less points than us, but because they win because of their division, they get home ice in the first round. The Avs do not. We had 107 points. They had 104. We get to go on the road for the whole playoffs. Well, unless we face Edmonton, because then we would be more points than Edmonton. But for the first round, they get home ice with less points than the third place team in the Central.
There have been some complaints about some of this.
They need to go through to 1-8 for the conference. This is stupid what they're doing.
Yeah, it is. Well,
I mean, your reward for getting first place is facing Las Vegas, the defending champions.
Yes, the current champions. Yeah, However, at the end of the day, you got to beat whoever's put in front of you, and that will always include at least one or two superb teams. Everyone could win. So,
it's true, but there are easier and harder routes.
Well, we've got a hard one because we're going to have to play if we get through Vegas, we're going to play you or the Jets.
Right.
Yeah, but you've also got Vegas gaming the system backing into the playoffs, you know, on purpose.
Yeah, they kind of did. I mean, they won that game.
It's not like they drew Las Vegas at where Las Vegas was clocking all these points. They were low man on the point scale out of their conference. It's just because they were doing just enough to make the playoffs till they could get their magic healing elixir.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Well, and Edmonton really could, if they had played that game, that could have also played into who they got in the first round. I mean, there are definitely some there was definitely some weird stuff going on there at the end, some gamesmanship going on by some different teams.
Strange games in the last couple of days. Yeah,
I know. They think we'd all be distracted by the whole Coyotes thing and wouldn't pay attention to this other stuff. But
yeah,
my favorite part of that whole story is how the NHL had to go in and make them pay their hotel bills.
Oh yeah,
really? Yeah. That Coyotes ownership had been stiffing the official partner hotels for travel games. And so when they arranged the sale out of the pro, they said they weren't going to release the proceeds till they went and paid all the hotels that they owed money to.
Well, did you see what else happened though? Shane Doan, his jersey, retired jersey, which was ended up in a dumpster.
He forgot it and forgot to take it with him when they took it down. And yeah, somebody found it and traveled to go find him and give it to him.
It ended in a dumpster, up in a dumpster. It's just crazy.
The weird thing is, I mean, the Coyotes can be revived. That's part of the deal.
Yes.
So if they happen to get, it's part of the deal that if they do get arena funding, the Coyotes come right back. You know, if it's 3 or 4 years down the road or 5 years. So all the cities that are sitting there wanting their expansion team, no, Utah is the expansion team at this point. They are not the Coyotes. They are a completely separate entity from the Coyotes at this point.
But isn't
they have all the Coyotes assets.
They're guaranteeing the same terrible Coyotes ownership. A team.
The ownership wasn't that bad. I mean, the issue is more political than it was anything.
Phoenix never should have had a team. Can kiss my butt on that. You know,
yeah,
the idea of Phoenix as a hockey town is ridiculous.
But people may have said the same about Tampa or Florida.
Or any of the three
Florida
teams.
Team is also stupid. Just the fact that they've managed to win cups doesn't make it not stupid that they're a hockey town.
Well, I think the advantage... Well, the same thing might have happened in Arizona. The advantage was there's a lot of Canadians there in the winter. So,
yeah, I mean, snowbirds.
Yeah, snowbirds. So I think they figured they're always going to get some tickets sold.
I, as a hockey fan, am so annoyed watching cup games in these really hot towns where the ice is crap by the time they get to the finals, where they're almost walking on slush puddles.
And the puck just stops moving.
Because there's no way in Tampa, Florida, to keep your rink cold in June and July enough
to... Yeah, when the playoffs are.
When the playoffs are going. Good and luck maybe that's an game. Advantage, man, because you got your home team gets used to slosh skating.
I think they need an outdoor game. Winter Classic in Tampa.
Well, I mean, the same thing could be said of Dallas, though.
But Dallas had a winter temperatures, classic, and it worked.
Right, but as far as temperatures in June and July, Dallas is just as hot as Florida, if not hotter.
Tell me about it. Speaking of Dallas, though, and we are speaking of Dallas, I got to find the right screen share here.
Fourth one down.
I've got it. Hang on.
But
I don't know what's going on here. There we go. I found it now. I wanted to show off a couple of we mentioned Ottinger earlier. He made two.
The paddle save in overtime.
The paddle save. There's two saves he made in that final game against the Blues. I thought we were going to suffer the indignity of losing that game because we really weren't. We like outshot them 3-1 yet again. Three couldn't score. Whatever. This is the overtime save that Ottinger made.
Yeah, I'm convinced he wasn't even paying attention and just stuck out the stick.
It's the luckiest, jammiest save we'd see in Scotland ever. So it's
they are calling it a magnificent save, and it's like he wasn't even paying attention.
He wasn't. Look at that. He's so far over there.
Where's the puck? Who cares?
Oh no, he got it.
It's the last game of the season.
He wasn't going to strain his groin to get that one.
Nope, not even going to try a little bit.
The fact that it tips, you think it normally would even just tip into the net, it goes
right
the other way.
From that angle, you would think he would have deflected it right back in instead of away.
Robert Thomas must have been saying, you know, I'm definitely going to get laid tonight because my luck was completely out there.
Yeah.
But he did. It was, and he said after in the interviews, he said, "Yeah, I just thought, you know, pretty much. I thought that's it. Game's over." He just stuck his arm out. It's funny though. It was
fun to watch, but that was a ridiculous, you know, turn of events there.
It was. This is the other.
I mean, people were calling that save of the year, and it's like, no, save of the year has to be something where you tried.
This is a better one. This is the one he did earlier in the game.
There it is. Perunovic.
Did a nice dive.
Yeah, that one at least. He didn't have to go into the splits. So he
it's like he's been
much
playing Helldivers an awful lot right there.
He probably has.
That's the Smoky special right there.
Yeah.
Jumping.
Yeah, run and double tap circle.
One final Stars thing. This is this is enough. This is in a field in Frisco, north of Dallas.
Man, the aliens are getting really fancy with their crop circles.
Someone's carved that.
It actually looks almost AI generated.
It could be, but I mean, there's a helicopter.
How do you get color in a crop circle like that?
You kill the grass.
Yeah.
You cut some of it in one direction, you kill the grass, or you just paint all of it like they do the NFL end zones.
Yeah, without actually seeing that in person, I feel like that is kind of like a fake thing where you just paste it onto the aerial.
Or Frisco actually is an interesting place because it's where the Dallas Stars office is, but the Dallas Cowboys training arena is there. It's better than most people's normal arenas. It's just a training arena.
Oh, the Cowboys?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. The Cowboys training arena. Yeah.
What's magic is it doesn't help them win in the regular season or playoffs.
Frisco's also going to get a huge.
I hope Matt is listening.
So. Matt's never listening.
I think it's Universal or somebody's going to build a theme park in Frisco.
Yeah.
Universal is planning on it.
They're putting the mid-country theme park that Disney talked about doing for a lot of years.
I have friends that live there. It's a pretty fast growing place. Hell of a distance out from the city center, though. It's like a 40-minute drive. It's quite crazy. Anyway.
Bell, it would have been better if Stone had been injured for the whole second half of the season. He was only injured from February like 20th.
I know.
A week before the trade deadline. If he had been injured for half of the season, I wouldn't be as up in arms about it. But this has happened for three straight years, maybe four straight years, that he has been injured between February 14th and 22nd, a week before the trade deadline, and then manages to be back on game one every time. And all the Vegas fans keep saying, well, I mean, you want your team to do everything that they can to win. It's like, yeah, well, if your organization is just known as cheaters, is it really winning at that point?
Asterisk. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's beyond something. I mean, I know it's the fault of the GMs who've had the chance to fix this and went, nah, something has to be done now. It's become a joke.
Yeah.
A total joke. I mean, yeah. Anyway.
Well, and kind of the funny thing about hockey, and I'm not sure how it is in other sports. I don't think it's the same way in other sports, but everybody got their last paycheck yesterday. They do not get paid for the playoffs until September. You get bonuses for the playoffs, but this is not part of the salary, which is why it's not part of the salary cap. Nobody gets a regular check for playing in the playoffs. Their salaries are completely paid up at this point. So it's kind of a weird thing. I mean, sure, you get, I believe you get bonused a certain amount depending on how far you go, but the next sanctioned payout for the players is in September when they come back to training camp.
I think I recall the NFL is similar, where they get playoff bonuses based on winning each game, or playing. You know, they get a bonus for being in the game, and then they get a winner bonus, but that's all they get paid. They're like to the point where eventually there's usually in the contracts there's a Super Bowl bonus level too. Like if you get to the Super Bowl, you get. But it's not. You're right. It doesn't count against the salary cap. It's just
because the salary cap only applies to regular season.
Yep.
Yeah, which is why teams like Vegas can manipulate the hell out of.
Well, the other leagues don't let that kind of shit go down though.
Yeah. Like, right.
I mean, it says a lot about the medical professionals involved that they'd be willing to go along with this. I think it's
The team trainers.
Yeah, who doctors are involved with this, or they should be if they're not, and they've got licenses. So,
well, we've all seen Any Given Sunday and Varsity Blues. The team trainer is always there on the side of let's win more than they are on the side of medicine in professional sports.
I don't think after 3 years in a row, Mark Stone doing this, I don't think you can say it's a coincidence.
Well, even the mainstream sports media is calling it out, saying, yeah, this has gotten to be a little bit stupid at this point.
Well, clearly the NHL wants it to happen. They love having Vegas be competitive like that.
Yeah, but they didn't give a leg up to Seattle, and Seattle's the newer team. I mean, only by a year or two.
Yeah, but they like I said, the NHL likes Las Vegas being a premier team.
Yeah, because it's a tourist. Hell, we were tourists last week, and we went and caught a game. Sure, it happened to be the Avs versus the Knights, and sure, it was a crap game for the Avs, at least.
I quite enjoyed it. I'm just kidding.
I'm sure you did.
Were you there wearing your Stars jersey too?
I was.
Yes, he was.
You were that guy.
He was that guy. There was a lot of those people there.
In jerseys. Other people were there in other jerseys. There was at least two other Stars jerseys.
That doesn't make it better.
And there were thousands and thousands of Avs jerseys. There were a ton of Avs jerseys there.
Oh, it reminds me of any time a team plays either the Commanders here in football in the D.C. area.
Yeah.
Or so Bourbon and Boarding Day out. And
Tampa Bay Rays in baseball.
And I left those glasses underneath my seat and forgot them.
Yes, you did.
Are they like actual nice expensive sunglasses?
No, they were Costco 2-pack for $20 or something.
Oh, that's better then.
So we've got a bit of the pre-match preamble, drum line.
The drum line.
Dancing girls.
And some very flat-chested cheerleaders.
Yeah. I don't know. I think we should have inspected them more closely.
All rejected from walking around on the strip or being in the showgirls.
Are you sure that none of them were enjoying their days of girlhood? It is Las Vegas.
That's possible. Hey, there's me way up in front of you because I didn't wait for you because I didn't know you stopped.
Well, I am not my brother's keeper. So.
And there's a guy twice the size of me.
Yeah. How'd you guys like the arena? Was it nice?
It's a nice arena. They've got a great presentation. They really keep the crowd pretty fired up throughout the game. I mean, they've got a lot of crap going on in every break. A lot more than I've seen the Avs do or most other teams do. And the pregame show is pretty good. I mean, they do the whole thing with the they tape whole vignettes for whatever team's coming in. And then it ends up with the knight out on the ice fighting somebody from the other team. I was surprised that there wasn't an avalanche that wiped out everything and then the knight crawled out of it, like climbed out of the snow or something, but that'd be a hard vignette to do without a whole bunch of snow to do it. And Vegas doesn't have a whole bunch of that.
It doesn't. I did find it overpoweringly loud, though. Like, not just loud, but overpoweringly loud.
Yeah, and it's also a very condensed arena. If you see, there's technically three levels, but it's not really three levels. Yeah, it's really two levels compacted on top of each other quite densely.
Yeah, I don't know if you can see my mouse, but up in the top left and right-hand corners, these bits that jut out, people stand there, and that's the haze lounge, which goes all around most of the top.
Yeah, it's like the rock pile at a baseball game, standing room only type thing.
Is Vegas getting a NBA team too? Do they have? I know they're getting baseball. They're getting the A's.
I
would have to care about the NBA to have any clue.
I was wondering if they would like if that arena is going to be multi-purpose for just hockey.
Yeah, so this was. This was right behind us, and this is where all the cheerleaders and drumline are for most of the game, is in that little fort.
And
I see the red tape behind you blocking off the plebes from the women.
Yes. So. Yeah, so, it was an enjoyable experience. We've got all the Western Conference teams on one half, you know, flags for each of them, and Eastern Conference teams on the other half.
It's so weird to see that the team, like this team already has like a cup banner up there.
Isn't it? They've got about four or five banners up there.
The thing that we noticed immediately, though, that on the negative side was the incredible prices. Now, most arenas are gouging fans now, but this one was they've got it to an art form in there. It was like $18 for a domestic beer.
For a beer, canned beer, it was $18.50.
Yeah,
that and their tickets are artificially high because of the tourist situation. Yeah. So, like. My season tickets, if I don't want to go to a game, I can typically sell them for right around face value, maybe $10, $15 more, depending on who's coming into town. But in Vegas, because there's so many tourists looking for tickets, when you're looking on like the ticket exchange for season ticket holders and stuff, they are still gouging the hell out of those tickets, you know, because there are enough tourists in town that will just go see a game. Doesn't matter who's playing. They just want to go experience it in Vegas. So we paid for the tickets what I would pay for four games of my season tickets.
Yeah, it was a bag of potato chips, crisps as I would call them, $5. Just like, this is crazy, you know. Even their own fans were complaining about it. You know, they just they suffer. It's just a little bit of the show.
That's loud. There.
Well, I had it down almost to zero. But yeah, you can see on the screen the sort of the mock battle, and then they come out onto the ice. Won't watch at all because there's a lot. Then the head coming down, helmet. So it's, you know, it's a big production. Let's flip forward, the players come out of that. Take the time about it. Now the subwoofer must be buried under the arena because
yeah,
feel it, yeah.
You can feel everything.
Yep. Got to compete with the orb or what's the name of that?
The
new,
sphere.
The sphere.
It was an interesting experience, and I mean, all teams have some kind of pregame thing with a lot of noise and whatever. But I felt that this one was so loud and so long that when it finished, it was like an anticlimax. Oh look, there's a game on now.
Oh yeah! You know. Now we've got to do the national anthem.
That's right. Now we've got to do the anthem. And he was a good singer. I can't remember his name, but he was good. It was a good anthem.
Yeah.
And then the game, it's like quiet after that. Like, it's pretty quiet.
And howdy, Sumo Orange.
Sumo Orange.
Thanks for
Tim's
joining.
Tim Stock was here. Hi.
Tim. Yeah, Tim Stock came in. Sign up for the bracket challenge, guys. If you want. I mean, it'll be going for the next month or two. So.
It's pinned in the chats.
You can be involved in this show.
Yep. You can laugh at my choices.
I'm pretty much assuming that I'll be the only one picking the Rangers to win the cup. So if they win, I win. There we go. Yeah,
you win. Well,
I've got the Avs over the Rangers.
You see, I've got Stars, Panthers in the final. But speaking of
you're crazy.
If I didn't have the Stars beating the Avs in the second round, that could have been a matchup. But instead, I have the Rangers over the Oilers for the Cup.
Oilers? Do you think the Oilers are going to get that far?
Yep. I got them beating the Stars to win the West.
Ooh.
Yes, but as it said on Wikipedia after the last time we played them, owner of the Edmonton Oilers, Dallas Stars. So... Some wag changed it. We should, as a courtesy though, finish out the Bourbon and Boarding Fantasy League.
I
first
guess.
Annual Fantasy League. Now, we learned a lot this year. So
yes,
next year we're going to try and get it going earlier and get more players and maybe tweak the rules a little bit because I think it was at like almost like unlimited changes, which...
I was changing unlimited in the same day.
I think you screwed yourself doing that, though.
I did, but I learned a lot because I've never done fantasy hockey before. So,
sitting proudly in first place is someone called Brian's Bourbon Stars.
No clue who that is.
No clue. Mikey D was a proud second, and then someone called Brahma's Bulls was third.
Yep.
And the winner had a fair points margin, I have to say. 8.5 points.
It's the humbleness in which you describe this.
Now,
the winner had a wide margin. It was a safe margin. Didn't you rack up all those points early when you were starting people?
Well, I did, but then I tweaked it back, and then I tweaked my strategy a little to go for certain categories.
Yeah, he really didn't have the lead for much of the year. Scroll up a little bit real quick. I wanted to look at some.
That way? Nope.
Up, not down. Go to the league. And I think that... Oh, no. Just understanding. It's got the chart view.
Oh, nope, right.
Left
here.
Nope. Up. Up. under where it says standings, then it says standings, and then it's got chart view. Look at where everybody charted for the season. So Brian took it right at the end of March. That's where he finally crossed over in the first place. Yeah. He had it a little bit in December. But that's kind of what the whole chart for the season looked like. It was really me, Mikey, and Brian kind of fighting it out through most of the season, just going up and down and up and down.
Bell peaked so, in January.
Yeah, but the chart view is kind of an interesting view of the whole season, just kind of showing where everybody was throughout the whole season. Since at the end, all it shows is the points, rather than kind of everything that was going on.
Isn't it the points that count on the last day, though?
Just on the last day, yeah. But I was just screwing around with things in there and found that chart view, and I was like, oh, well, that's interesting.
I prefer this one.
Yeah, the one where you didn't do anything for the last 2 weeks and got it.
Oh, I ditched every player except goalies. I was just frantically trying to find goalies.
Oh, you didn't ditch everybody but goalies. You got the power play points were what got you the extra lead instead of the 2-point lead.
Yeah.
I paid enough attention to know what's going on there.
I'm hearing some hostility.
It's not hostility until you start lying and saying, no, I only played goalies. I watched you get like 6 power play points in the last 2 days.
But I couldn't have. I ran out of other players. I didn't run out of defenders. And that was Saros. Sorry, not Saros. Yossi. Sorry, keep saying Saros. Yossi got a couple. But yeah, I did finish 5th, so all the categories. 5, 6, 5, 6, 4, 6, 6, 6, 6. 2.5.
Chance, yeah. So. Power play anyway, points it was a lot of fun. Killed me.
It was a lot of fun. We'll do it again next year, but next year we'll have an earlier show to get it all set up and get everybody to sign up live and try and get...
Yeah, we'll try to do a show to get sign-ups. We'll still do the live draft, like last weekend before we can possibly start it. But that way, maybe we can get a few more sign-ups, in that 2 or 3 weeks leading up to it.
Yeah, so it was fun. Very different. I'd never done a rotisserie league before. It's always head-to-head.
But I think that's perfect for a show like this, because... Then, everybody's involved every week, no matter what.
Yeah.
We could also take a poll on that and see what people think.
Yeah, but the other league I'm in, I ended up 4th out of 12. Just by tiniest of margin in all the playoff ones. I could have beaten first and ended up first, but it was like 1 point difference. One or two categories difference.
We'll have to get Bill to actually draft anything other than centers next year.
League of centers. Well, I think what we'll do next time is, and I didn't set it this time, and I think you can, is you have to draft certain. It won't let you draft more than a certain number.
Well, remember, she couldn't log into the draft, so it was auto-drafting just whoever was the top player available. She got a goalie and then center.
I like that.
And it wasn't McDavid. She got McKinnon. You got McDavid in the overall number one pick.
Yeah. It was fun, though.
Yeah, I'm glad we did it. It'll be fun to do in the coming years, too.
I'm just going to ask you gentlemen to carry on without me for a minute.
All right. We'll make fun of the Rangers a little bit since Chad's here. So since we didn't do a show last week, this was a... major controversy that happened in the week before that we didn't get to show any clips from. So here's what we have in the Rangers game. Zibanejad, looking up the ice, runs into an Islanders player also looking up the ice. And the Rangers coach had the audacity to say it was one of the dirtiest hits he'd ever seen. And it was obviously targeting his head. It's like, yes, clearly Zibanejad was targeting his own head by skating directly into the guy's shoulder, because neither of them is looking, and there's no way in hell you could say that that the Islanders player was actually trying to hit him. He was just standing there at the ice. Uh-huh. He's directly in the center ice. The Titantron is directly above him. You can't see the Titantron from there. I'm in these arenas every 2 or 3 Oh, Chad, now you're starting to sound like Slender or Mad trying to defend or not defend three-body problem and just coming up with arguments that make no sense. So, yeah. So Zibanejad goes to the locker room injured from skating into a person under his own power. Yeah. And then I think I've got one more video from the Rangers. Yeah, this one is not actually from the Rangers, but it is applicable to the Rangers because, as we all know, Rempe has been on a tear. So I pulled some footage of his old WHL career. And this is a player he's now playing for the Senators, and he actually got called up in the last week just for the game with the Rangers. But this is them in the WHL.
Rempe. Rempe. And Zach Ostapchuk are swinging him, and Ostapchuk drops Rempe.
So Rempe is human. He can be taken out by somebody half a foot smaller than him.
If that won't get you going, I don't know what
good.
Will.
Yeah.
And I actually like Rempe, so I just thought this was funny because he's got a huge size advantage on everybody, and he gets rocked in this one.
The other guy was quick with the first punch.
Yeah, well, and when Rempe whiffed, he just went straight at the chin and drilled him. So
get you going, I don't know what will.
That is sick.
You got to be ready to do it.
Well, there's an art to it because your hand that you are not throwing as a punch, you have to have a grip in a certain way to where when the guy's trying to punch you, you just jab them in the chin with their own shirt and your hand and get ready with the big load up. So
yeah, and now they don't let you pull the jersey over their head to beat them down.
It's a shame.
That'll get you in trouble, and the fight straps kind of keep that from happening.
Yeah.
I love when people, I have the authentic jerseys, and when I wear them, they're like, what the hell are those things? I'm like, those are the fight straps.
Those strap to your pants.
Yeah, they connect to your pants so you can't pull the jersey over your head.
And they flap about behind you if you're just wearing a jersey casually like we do.
Yeah.
Yeah, casually. It keeps you from being casually Brahmed if you're in a hockey arena or in a fight.
Yeah.
Hello, Taylor Swift, greater than Disney, Star Wars, and MCU.
How's it going? So, those are my Rangers clips. Just getting ready for the Rangers to probably roll over half of the league.
I do have some New York-related clips, but it's not the Rangers.
I am wearful of winning. You win the President's Cup, and you usually don't win.
Only eight teams have done it.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it is appropriate. Like, if the Rangers are going to win a cup, it would be to break curses. So.
That's why the Stars deliberately lost to Chicago in the last few games so they could finish just behind you.
Sure.
So this is not NHL. This is the NYPD.
Yep.
Against the FDNY, Guardians of the Public Safety and Morals. And this is the shenanigans they get up to at the end of their game.
5 seconds remaining. Nobody has control. The clock winds down. And once again, the fire department champions in New York City.
Yeah, it's not over yet.
Oh, here we go, boys. Center ice, they're going. Center ice fight. It's Antonitis. Oh, it's Beretta. It's Kyle.
It's nice to know that these are the calm, level-headed people guarding our safety.
Oh, yeah.
Well, look, do you see what arena they're playing in? Hockey players, when they play in an Islanders rink, just automatically become dirty assholes.
Just become violent dirty.
Yeah. It's the Islanders, man. It just seeps into you. You gotta deal with it. I mean, in that arena, dirty players are capable of backing into people to hit them in the head.
Yeah. So that was that's not the only clip from that game, though. There's another one I wanted to show.
Is it the Selly?
The Selly. Should I show?
I've got
the
it. I'll just go ahead and pull it up because I've already got it ready to go.
You got it. All right. I'll close. I'll come out of this.
We're going to get a look at this celly here, Whit.
It's like Dennis Quaid, the rookie.
All right, what'd you see here from Gargan?
Gargan, so he
he's saying, hey, boys,
this is the
FDNY. We're doing a training session.
The fire department.
We're going to get down, stay low, below the fire. And he's going to say, hey, there's a door. I feel some heat. Let's get into this, baby. And there he is right there.
The fire, the firefighter axe chopped to the door to get through the door
away.
And
they
stay below the
door.
Smoke.
The boys are in there to put
Celly
out the blaze.
Of the year.
It's awesome.
Great work by our crew. So, capturing right, so
does,
that. All smiles
does
on the
FDNY
bench.
FDNY get the Islanders Arena as their home rink, and the police get
Rangers
Madison
get
Square
MSG.
Yeah.
I don't know. But there's been a lot of clips from them this year. This is just the first night I've actually pulled some of them. Yeah. I don't know how often these guys play against each other, because it seems like there's clips like every month.
Does every department, like, does the Port Authority have a hockey team? The sanitation workers have hockey teams? Like, is this a whole league of government employees?
I don't know, but it's nice to see them playing something other than old man softball.
Well, clearly the FDA, the NYPD isn't needed on the streets in New York, so they've got time.
It's safer beating each other up than being out in the streets.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it's a big deal. It's in a proper arena. It's got television coverage. It's a big crowd, so it seems like a big
deal. Yeah, the crowd seems very large.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, well, if you just get the families of firefighters and police officers, that's enough to fill arenas in New York.
Probably. So
and they're probably hyped about it. It's good stuff. I mean, it is nice to, you know, it looked like they were actually capable of playing at a decent level, too. It wasn't.
I think
just
the game was
6-5.
It was 5-5, and an empty netter made it 6-5. So it went down to the end of that game.
I thought it was 6-5, and they added, and the empty netter made it 7-5.
No, they didn't. They finished 6-5. Yeah, that was.
If it was 5-5, why the hell are you pulling your goalie?
Because there's only one game between them, or I don't know. Maybe it's the championship, and they just decided we're going for it. They may have rules that don't include going to overtime, and nobody wanted to see it end in a tie.
Yeah, it's
maybe
an NYPD move.
Maybe Torch was advising them.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like, it's like pulling your goalie in overtime, so you lose the point.
Yep.
So we do have some goals and stuff from tonight's games. But this is, you must have seen this on Twitter. This is at the Blue Jays game, and it's a Maple Leafs fan checking his phone, and he sees the score, and it's like 4-0.
Does he cry like a baby?
He's putting on a Jays shirt over the. He's giving up.
Getting rid of the Maple Leafs jersey.
That's right. He's had enough. He checked his phone. Oh shit.
You know, it's funny. I think the Blue Jays have won a championship more recently, and or even a playoff series more recently.
Oh,
than
far
the
more
Leafs,
recently,
right?
Well, no, they won their first series last year, didn't they? Didn't they get to round two last year?
The Jays have won the whole thing before.
I know, but Chad said even a series.
I don't know. I just feel
last year Toronto got to round two last year and then got absolutely
got to
demolished
round two last year, because that was, they were convinced they were going to win the whole thing then.
God, yeah. Toronto! If Toronto like wins one game in a series, their fan base thinks that somehow they're going to win a cup.
Well, they are rabid and crazy.
They can be down 3-0, manage to pull one game out, and then they're going to be like, "We're going to the cup. We're going to come back. It's amazing. You were the best team of all time. We're destiny."
This is a tasty hit by Maroon from tonight's game.
Is this the bench hit?
Three-time Stanley Cup champion Pat Maroon with the big hit.
He slaps him on the ass just for emphasis.
That got the game off to a start.
Three-time Stanley Cup champion Pat Maroon with the big hit.
Well, and Marchand, immediately at the faceoff, they were already chirping at each other.
Yeah, it was fairly tasty. I did get a couple of the goals. This is the second goal from the game. Carlo, I think. You could feel the hope draining from the Toronto fans.
Yeah.
Yeah, you'd think that would have already happened, but it's all right.
What a bad slapper. And then Will? I think this is the gate. Oh no, it's the wrong game. Sorry, never mind.
So do your other clip, and then we've got to do what we did last year, and it'll take a few minutes, but this will end the show. Last year we did a bourbon and boarding bracket, amongst the bracket challenge. So we'll go through real quick and just look at each matchup and, you know, let the chat decide who's going to win each matchup and make a bourbon and boarding bracket as well. Because tonight's the only night we have to do that. So
just I'll play this briefly. This was the game winner. No, this was the fourth. So not a good night for the Leafs defense or Samsonov. I mean, I watched most of the game. It was, outside of Riley, their defense is...
That goal looks almost like it's straight out of Party Animals when Brahma just abuses us on the hockey thing.
Sometimes.
You got the defender just coming in late, just being like, I can't do anything. It's just a goal.
And then Slender Dad quits like Ottinger did, except he sticks out a stick every now and then.
I think Ottinger's quite right. He's suffered a lot of injuries. He didn't want to extend himself. That was a lost cause. He just goes like this.
Yeah, it was just crazy that the stick actually touched it.
That's funny. Yeah, so what are we going to do now then? So,
Well, you're already in there, right? Do you want to just create another bracket under you, and we'll figure out how to bring it into the league later, or we'll just pull it up every week. But
so let's see if I can,
can do it, or I can try to get back in there.
You can do it. I can do it.
Oh, that's Mike saying doesn't help when the first shot of the game goes in. That's because they were playing the Maple Leafs, so it was just going to happen. So it's fine.
I mean, that seems like they might have been playing Georgiev for the Avs.
So I can create a new bracket.
Yeah.
I don't know if it'll come out under my name or...
It will, but you can rename the bracket to Bourbon and Boarding Bracket. And then we will just figure out how to bring it in to our league, or we will bring it up separately every week.
Oh, max 20, so I'll just call it Bourbon and Boarding.
All right, so chat, we need your participation. We need to know. Well, let's start in the West. We'll just go from left down and then right down. So Dallas and Vegas Knights. I think we obviously know who me and Brian and I think Chad think is going to win. I'm going with Dallas here. I think Brian's going with Dallas, obviously. And little Chad is going with Dallas. So who do you guys think is going to win the matchup? We'll give you about 30 seconds, and then we'll lock in that.
Yeah, and Dallas. It was the matchup I didn't want. I wanted the Kings.
Everybody wanted the Kings. Yeah, I think that's why Edmonton maneuvered.
Yes. I really didn't want to have to knacker ourselves.
We are picking brackets for the channel bracket challenge, Keely Chow. So do you think Dallas is going to beat Vegas, or Vegas will beat Dallas in the first round?
So we're right up here, Dallas, Vegas. We've got Mike thinks Dallas.
It looks like Dallas is overwhelmingly taking
Dallas,
it.
And he's got Dallas.
That actually
six.
Worries me now about the pick. I hate consensus. Makes me when all experts
the bourbon and boarding bourbon and boarding brackets last year got busted really bad, so this should worry Brian because the bracket got destroyed in the first round
last year we've only had two opinions. That's Mike and Sumo, and they both say Dallas.
No, we got little Smokey. Chad, we got no, Southern Smokey, Bell, Southern we got Smokey.
Oh, yeah, sorry, I'm not looking at those.
So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five are picking Dallas. I'd say that's the consensus because
if nobody we has put like in Vegas ESPN, yet. If we're doing an ESPN style argument at the end, it would say the consensus is Dallas like in six.
So we're going for Dallas.
All right.
Okay.
Winnipeg. And there's E. Clay with Dallas as well. So next matchup, Winnipeg versus Colorado. This is a Central Division 2 versus Central Division 3. I will go with the Avalanche, even though I am very worried about this.
I'd go with the Avs, yep.
I'm very worried about this matchup.
Which goalie are you going to play?
Actually, Coach declined to say it today.
Yeah,
he said both goalies are ready to go. Georgiev has looked like crap for about 3 weeks now.
Yeah.
And Eustace has looked he looked pretty good against Edmonton, of course, without Edmonton's stars. So
you can tell how bad Gorgiev looked because nobody wanted to pick him up at the end of our fantasy league, even though he was free. Nobody wanted.
I had him all season. He had the most wins in in the league. I mean, he did win the most games out of all goalies in the league this year. So we got Little Chad, Avs, Krimlon. He's got a feeling the Avs will be out, so that's a non-Avs. Bell, Avs, DiCarlo, Avs, Smokey, Avs, Keeley Chow, Avs, Eklay, Avs.
Keeley's no surprise, because Keeley doesn't want the Jets.
So. And Sumo Orange, Avs, so I would say that is an Avs consensus there.
All right,
next matchup, Vancouver versus Nashville. Possibly the hottest team going into the end of the season versus the most surprising team in the league this year in Vancouver. Vancouver was not expected to do anything this year, and they end up winning the Pacific. I actually took Nashville.
I did too. Yep.
Okay, we got Little Chad, the Canucks, Smokey, the Canucks,
Mike
DiCarlo, Vancouver, Krimlon, Nashville, Keeley, Nashville. So that's me, you, and Krimlon, and Keeley. So that's four versus Nux. That's 4-on-4 right now.
Oh, shit.
Sumo Orange comes in with Canucks. Eklay comes in with Nashville. That's a tie at 5-5 right now.
You got Bell saying Vancouver?
Yep. That was during my Nux. All right, we need one more vote. Anybody out there that can give us one more vote? Nashville or Vancouver?
Chad? What did you say?
Chad said Canucks. The Canucks.
Okay, we need one. By the way, this is the chat bracket. You can still all do your own. Those who have not done a bracket, you can do your own personal one too, please. We need one, as many as possible.
Yeah, and I need to get my link into the YouTube. I'll change over to the Canucks and say that the Canucks are going to win. So
we're going for Canucks.
Yep.
Final call. Last call. Okay, it's Canucks. Although that was a tight one. We'll remember that.
That was a tie.
A lot of people wanted the Preds. Yep. The slimy Oilers.
It's Oilers. I mean, against the Kings.
I just mean that in the oil sense, not any the people from Edmonton or the team are slimy. Oil is a slimy, sticky stuff, horrible stuff. Against the Kings, so I think I bucked the trend on this, and I went Kings.
Really?
Okay. I did. I went Kings.
I thought this one was one of the safest, probably the safest matchup on the West.
Have you seen the Oilers' defense and goaltending?
Yeah, but I've also seen the Kings. They're very young and inexperienced. They were not expected to be here either.
But there's always a surprise one, and I put this as my surprise one.
All righty. At least you didn't pick the freaking Caps over the Rangers as your surprise or something crazy like that. What is the password for the league? It's Dallas.
It's Go Stars 2024.
Go Stars 2024. If you decide to sign up from my chat in the linked comment, Go Stars 2024 is the password for the league. All right, let me count up.
I think it's looking pretty much Oilers. I don't see anybody saying the Kings.
Southern Bell and Krimlon said Kings.
Oh, right.
Kings, Southern Bell, Krimlon, Oilers.
Two Kings.
One, two, three, four Oilers, five Oilers versus two Kings, and I took the Oilers, so that's six Oilers versus three Kings. So Edmonton is the pick there.
All right, now we've got to do how many games?
Dallas and six would be.
This is going to be too hard for a chat to do. I'd say we just put six across the line.
Well, Sumo said Dallas and six anyway, so let's.
I'd say six across the board for everybody instead of trying to get a pick for each different.
I think the Oilers do it in five in their series, but that's just me.
I mean, if anyone's got another opinion about the Oilers Kings, now's your time to speak up. Or any of these. Otherwise, it's going to be sixes across the board, otherwise, I guess. Or five for the...
I mean, because ultimately the chat's just picking the bracket. I mean, you're not going to get a consensus on games, usually.
No. Well, we'll put sixes across the board then, despite Chad's...
Smokey had my back. He said Edmonton and five. But I'm just saying.
Yeah, well, Smokey's crazy, and we know that.
Well, there's a lot of people saying five. There's two now. They've said five for that.
Well, three with Chad.
What should we do? I don't care. Either.
Other, just go
well,
six Smokey's
saying Edmonton and five. I mean, I would say we just keep it across the board at a five or a six.
Well, I'm happy with that.
Yeah, I mean, because this really doesn't... I mean, if chat bracket actually happens to guess every series correctly as far as who's the winner, we'll call chat great and...
we will.
Not worry about what the series were for points and stuff. So let's go over to the East. Florida versus Tampa Bay.
Panthers. Florida. Bolts. Panthers, Bolts. I put Panthers.
I've got the Panthers all day long.
So all three of us say Panthers. Let's see what is chat think.
Mike's got Tampa.
There's another Panthers. There's a Tampa. Panthers. Bell. Panthers.
Southern Bell doesn't like 666. Well, it's 6666, so we're okay.
Panthers.
Seems like, yeah, this is the most consistent one.
Yeah, that's everybody's about 8-2 Panthers versus Tampa Bay.
So Mike will turn out to be right, and it'll be Tampa.
Well, he's also going to pick the Maple Leafs, so that's
good. What?
I don't think he'll pick the Maple Leafs. He saw him play tonight.
He's a realist, not a fantasist. It's fantasy, of course. So, next one, Boston Leafs.
Oh, Bruins.
Which we already know one. We already know that there's going to be at least one.
I'm thinking the Bruins sweep, but...
Yeah.
After last year getting swept in the first round, yeah.
So, what do we got? We got Sumo's Boston.
Got the Bs.
Bell's Boston.
That's three Bs plus three on screen, right? You all picked the Bs?
I did.
Yeah, Mike saying right. Bruins. I picked Leafs in my bracket, though.
So that's seven for the Bs. Eight for the Bs. The Bs have it.
Mike says Bruins, but he picked Leafs in his own bracket.
And E. Clay goes with maple syrup. So that's 8-1.
8-1. I think we'll say Bruins. You see, Mike, you should look at it this way. If we all pick that, then it's possible the other way will go. So.
And yeah. From Rumble... I think it's Aldog or Aldog 0323 says Boston. Last series the Leafs beat the Bees was 1974.
Yes, a mere 7 years after their last cup win, Stanley Cup win.
All right. So we've got the Rangers and the Capitals. Aldog. The Capitals being the worst goal differential in history to get into the playoffs, and the Rangers being
be another sweep.
President's Trophy winning beast. Team.
Yeah.
Rangers.
I've got the Rangers all the way here.
I will say this. The Rangers and Caps are just a weird, like, they are a angry matchup and always have been my entire life. I don't know. The I-95 teams with the Rangers are always, like, just fights and this and that.
Logic says the Rangers, but this is the kind of weird one that every year throws everyone into a loop.
And Sumo's taking the Caps.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just it has the potential to be a weird trap thing, you know.
Yeah, but so I don't think they'll fall.
Nine Rangers versus one Capitals at the moment.
Aldog says Rangers. Rangers.
The Capitals any other year, I might give them a chance, but they suck this year. I'm not sure how they squeaked in.
Yeah. You know, they also lost their new stadium too.
Yeah, the top of the East is good. And then there is a massive drop off.
Sumo has been forced to say Rangers, even though he hates Rangers. So, okay, so
yep, Rangers 9-1 there.
Yeah, and then
all right, Canes Islanders. Patty Waugh's boys versus WG's home team.
Yeah, I have to go Canes in this one. And not just because of tonight, just
I'd have been going the Canes either way because Patrick Waugh's insane. I love the guy, but he's insane. Although he did do a magic trick getting them into the playoffs.
He did.
It helps that the East was, the like East? You said, top heavy.
I think I did say at the start of the season I thought they were going to make the playoffs. So
I mean, half
I think
the teams
we both did,
their...
but in a surprising way. I mean, they got there. We thought they would be stronger than what they were. They just kind of ended up getting there.
I think Sumo's tagged it. Capitals win it in four and beat the Rangers 10-0 every period. So 30-0 score in each game.
That would help make up their goal differential.
Yeah. Well, one game would make up the goal differential for the season.
Sumo is giving the Isles a sympathy vote, but I think the Canes are winning. So.
All right, so we got the Canes
never,
in this one.
Never give the Islanders sympathy.
Yeah, and nope. Six across the... Yeah. Says a Rangers fan. Six across the board.
Yep. I think.
Right. Now we get to the conference final.
All right, chat. This is so where you guys got to actually...
Who's going to get through to the conference final from Dallas versus Colorado?
Dallas.
My heart says Dallas. My head says, from past experience, the Avs. Dallas.
I'm taking the Avs because I'm a homer.
So I'll take Dallas just to be a homer.
All right. So we got... Two on stream. All right, so there's three now with Sumo versus two with DiCarlo. Smokey is the Avs. Gremlon's the Avs. That's...
I'm not offended if people say Avs.
That's 4-3.
Oh, me too, Sumo. I've got Dallas and Florida in the final.
Aldog. Bell says Avs. That's, 6-3 Avs.
Okay. That's it, I think, because
we've been getting about 10, 9 to 10, so.
It seems like the Avs, yeah.
All right.
Alrighty. Click on the right one. Okay.
That worries me, based on the...
Past experience.
Based on the chat picks last year.
Right. Second half of that second round, so Canucks-Oilers.
Battle
of Canada. A Canadian battle. If it came to those two, I think I'd pick the Canucks.
This year, I think I've got to take the Canucks, even though I think in my bracket I took Edmonton, because I think it's inevitable to have Dallas or Colorado have to face Edmonton to get there.
Yeah, I say Oilers. Sumo says Oilers.
Oilers. Mike says Canucks.
I just love watching Edmonton lose in the conference finals and never, ever get to the actual dance.
Yeah.
Because screw McDavid and the rest of them. That
it's a one-line team.
Yeah, they built their team around two players and refused to take any pay cuts.
If you can suppress those guys, their defense and goaltending is terrible. So.
Correct. All right, so we got one Oilers, two Oilers, three Oilers.
But that's the thing where it's going to be weird. I bet, like, their goaltending is going to get hot. You know, like, one of those where the goaltender gets hot and they ride it to the cup finals to lose to the Rangers.
All right, so we got Chad at 3-3. I'm taking the...
And I said...
I'm still saying Edmonton, so that's 4-3. You're taking the Canucks.
So you're saying you're going to take the Oilers?
I'm taking the Oilers. Well, you're taking the Canucks. Okay, that's 4-4. Chad, you're the tiebreaker.
Oh, I say Oilers.
Okay, Oilers.
Come on, there must be somebody who hasn't spoken up yet.
Chat's been silent for a minute and a half.
All right, okay, it's the Oilers.
All right, Panthers versus the Bees.
Oh, this is tough. I'd still pick the Panthers.
I will too.
I think I had the Bruins for this one.
All right, so that's 2-1 on stream. Chat, what do we got? Panthers, Bruins. Panthers, Bruins. So that's 3-2. Bruins, that's 4-2. 5-2.
I
5-3 Smokey goes Panthers.
Okay.
Am I doing that right?
No,
No, we took Panthers. So
we took Panthers.
Yeah. So it's 3-3 at the moment. So
1-3
No. 4-3 5-3
For the Bruins. For Boston.
Now, 1-4 Four Bruins in the chat plus Chad. So that's 5. Panthers, we've got Sumo, me, you, Smokey. That's 4. That's 9 votes with the Bees taking it.
I demand a recount.
I just did.
So who said Bruins? Mike?
Bruins, DiCarlo, Kremlon, Bell, Aldog, or Aldog, and Chad. That's Chad. 5. Panthers was Sumo, Smokey, me, and you. That's 4. Okay. That's so, 5-4.
Okay, I submit.
Boston. I mean, technically, our votes really shouldn't count because this is the chat That's bracket. True, but we didn't start that way, so we're stuck going with what we did.
This is the collective everybody.
Yeah, this is everybody bourbon and boarding. Yes. All right, Rangers and Panthers. Or no, Canes. Hurricanes. Panthers. What am I thinking? Rangers and Canes.
Rangers.
So those are Rangers. I'm going to go Canes.
I'm going Rangers.
I suspect Sumo, the Rangers will take my heart. Good job,
Sumo's
Albo.
Sumo's Canes as well, but Sumo and I are, I believe, the only two Canes, probably. And WG is not here. He's obviously not here anymore. So.
Right. Chad, you went Rangers?
Yeah.
Okay.
Kremlin's Canes, Sumo's Canes, I'm Canes, Aldog's Rangers, Bell's Rangers.
That's 5-6
Sumo says...
7. Sumo 7 says, Rangers... Sumo's 7 Rangers versus
there's only been three Canes. Okay.
7-3 Rangers.
Let's get rid of Rangers then.
All right. The big round.
The big
conference
one.
Finals.
Oh. Avs have to beat Canadian team, and then we got an original 8 matchup over on the East.
I know that if it has to be, if it was Avs Oilers, I'd take the Avs.
I'm taking the Avs if it's Avs Oilers, yeah.
Oilers.
We've already done it to them at least twice, right?
So 2 Avs, 1 Oilers so far. Mike says Avs.
Screw you, Chad.
Screw you.
Avs. That's 5 Avs. That's 6 Avs with Smokey.
We've only had 1 Oilers.
Yeah. That's insurmountable. With the numbers we've got, there's 7 Avs, so Avs take.
Avs it is.
And the Bees versus the Rangers.
Rangers.
This instance, Rangers, yeah.
So that's 3 Rangers. Aldog says Rangers. That's 4 Rangers.
It would be interesting because I think the West has been way stronger this year. It would be interesting.
Man, Sumo has as much hate for the Rangers as I have for the Islanders.
Sumo Orange abstained.
That's 6-2.
I feel the hate
with an abstain. So 6-2 with an abstaining vote, Rangers.
Oh, Brahma, this would be the Stanley Cup matchup that could impact our friendship.
This is the one that I said at the trade deadline would happen. I changed it from Canes and Avs to Avs and Rangers at the trade deadline.
Well, if I saw this matchup, and my apologies, Chad, I would say Avs.
Of course.
My heart says Avs, but I think the Rangers are the better team this year, but I'm going to go with Avs for the bracket.
I'm not saying Avs because they're in any way vastly superior. I just feel that's the way it would go.
I think we've got more Stanley Cup final experience, obviously.
Then yeah, the Rangers haven't been there in a while now. So.
And well, I mean, we really only have about 25% of our team left that won the cup from 2 years ago, but that's more than the Rangers, I think. So Avs.
Oh, my Death Admiral's letting me down.
Rangers. Well, he's an Avs fan. What do you expect?
I think he is an agent of the automatons here to try to sabotage Super Earth.
The city of NY can suck it.
I see three Rangers. So Avs.
See some Avs.
Yeah, Avs to take, it looks like.
So we're settled. I can click it.
Yeah, the number.
The answers that are out there, Avs taken. All right.
Okay, number of goals scored. Let's see what people say.
In the final series, not.
I think
this is just in the Avs Rangers.
We should let the chat throw their numbers in. Give us your estimate and we'll take the average.
Keep in mind that he's named Forgiev for a reason.
So 69.
That's a bit
high.
That'd
be a lot of goals. I mean, I would say somewhere.
He's obviously going with only four games. It's a sweep for the Avs.
It's the Matthews strategy.
The most common number of games in a hockey series is six. It is just
the final they're talking about, not the entire playoffs.
Yep.
Yeah, just the final series.
All right, okay.
But Sumo's obviously picking the Avs in four with 69 goals between the two teams in four games.
Well, it's the only number we've...
And Krimlon says, 12 to shuck it, New York.
Southern Bills probably
shuck
closes.
It long and shuck it odd.
Anywhere between 30 and 40 makes the most sense. Probably it's going to take about six games usually.
So we've got 69, 35, 23, and 12. It's quite a spread.
Well, that's what they're going with. I mean, just from watching, I'd have to say it's going to be like a 5-4 win every single game. So 54 goals. No, I'd say realistically 38 is my guess.
So I think obviously 12 is just a joke from Krimlin. That's never going to be right. I think 23.
No, I think he's saying 12 and they're all Avs and New York can suck it. They're going to score zero goals.
Yeah, basically it would be a four-game sweep and they get three goals a game.
Yeah.
3-0
I don't think
it's going to
be that low.
Do you remember one of my favorite series was the Canucks Bruins, Cup, where the Bruins would beat them like 6-1, and then the Canucks were winning like 1-0 or 2-1 in the games they won, and it went to 7. So by the 7th game, the goal differential was retardedly in Bruins' favor, but it was like
30-4.
Yeah.
So how are we going to do this? I could add them up and do an average.
Yeah, I can do that real quick.
12 plus
23. 69,
35, 23,
12,
69.
27, 56. Is there any more? Divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That would be...
We've got a 56 and a 27.
An error. That would be 37, which is about right where I think it is.
So how many people give a number?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, we count the 12 from Krimlon.
We got Eakley at 56. You got that one?
Yep. I'm counting up with 37 even.
All dog
222 divided by 6.
And you came up with?
37 even.
Yeah, that's what I've got. Sorry. So I was just double checking. So we've got 37 is the average of all those without the three of us saying anything.
Right.
So that's fine.
Yep.
I'm okay with that.
Chad kind of threw in his 2 cents, anywhere from 35 to 40. I said 38.
Yeah.
You didn't really say anything. But yeah, I think 37, 38 is about right for a 6 or 7 game series.
Yeah, I mean, 7 games, 5 goals, 35. So that's the low end, probably. So. So yeah. Let's say 37, yeah?
Yep.
It is.
That's what chat said.
Okay.
All right.
Successfully saved.
So Colorado over the Rangers for the Stanley Cup with 37 goals scored in the final series.
I respect the will of the chat, but I disagree vehemently.
I bet you do. quite frankly, it's very close to my bracket, and I disagree. Mine's going with my heart, not my head, because I think this is Dallas's year, at least from the West. I think it's Dallas versus the Rangers, if I'm going with what I'm seeing from the actual games right now.
So, bourbon and boarding bracket. I need to assign it.
Check need to the figure box a way to get it in.
Just check my leagues over to your right. It says my leagues. Just check that box.
It's a checkbox right next to create a league.
Yeah. And then there you
then
go.
Then put it in the bourbon and boarding.
I was trying to find it.
Yeah, you didn't click add. You just clicked into the league. Click back.
There's the bracket. Assign a league. This is where you do it. Assign a league.
Yeah, then go to the right, I think, to select it, not go into the league itself. The green link.
No, it just comes back to my bracket.
Well, that's because he's picking the bracket he wants to use in that league.
Mm.
So what I'm trying to do is take this bracket.
Assign a league.
The bourbon, assign a league, and this is where it comes to. If you click in here.
If we have to, we'll recreate this bracket with my alternate email and plug it in as bourbon and boarding.
Because it's not.
You've got the picks, so that's all we need.
It's not letting me add it.
Right,
yeah, because you're
only
have
one
bracket.
The problem I found earlier with another second bracket, it won't let you add it. So we'll figure that out.
Yeah.
We've got a week to figure that out.
Well, Al Dog, since you participated tonight, I hope you come back for the rest of the playoffs. We're here every Saturday.
Yeah.
We'll be covering the playoffs. We'll be going over the brackets and looking at the brackets that were chosen tonight and see what happens. But yeah. I think there is a link in Brian's chat that will let you join in with your own bracket
it's
as well,
right,
if you would like.
In the pinned to the top of the chat in Rumble.
But so, we're at an hour and 32 minutes, I think.
Just wanted to say hi to Snow Dub. Don't worry about it, mate. Thanks for dropping by, buddy. And also just to look at the brackets, we've got me, Eclay, Sumo, Chad, Southern Bell, Mike DiCarlo, Smokey so far. Anyone else? Click on the link, get in there, get a bracket in. But that's pretty good. Thanks, guys.
I think we've got 2 days left to solidify the brackets.
Yeah, so the winner gets 1,000 virtual in their head dollars that don't exist in any shape or form. You get bragging rights, Eclay. What more do you want?
Yeah, although we can't remember who won last year.
No, not a clue. I got to find. Oh, there we go. I'm looking for this. That's it. That's it. We're out of that. So, yeah. Cool.
All right. So, yeah, we're at an hour and a half. Yeah. Thank you, everybody, for hanging out. Chad, what do you got coming up? Saddle. Good talk. 70s,
nice.
What do you got coming up?
Nice talking to you, Chad. It's been real. Monday. Whatever I'm doing tomorrow, there might be stuff going on. I don't know. Monday on my channel, after a couple of weeks' absence, throat's nearly gone, we'll be doing an edition of Cult Comedy Crew about one of my favourite comedy shows of all time, the joint British-Irish production Father Ted, classic Channel 4 comedy, just funniest thing you've never seen. If you guys have never heard of it or seen it, it's a hilarious comedy about three priests on a remote island off the west coast of Ireland. Doesn't it already sound funny?
I think you've told me about it before. I've never gone and checked
it out.
It's
hilarious. I was watching some of it again today to pick clips, and I just couldn't stop laughing. So Father Ted it is, to be sure, Begorra.
All right.
That's on Monday, 3 p.m. on my channels. And how about you, my friend?
Well, I think Chad's back because he was just flashing, which means he was unmuted. So, Chad, what do you got coming up?
Just Tuesday game streams we do on your channel, which I like to enjoy and have a good time doing. And then on Fridays, 9 p.m. Eastern time, we do our show on the Ascendant Art Podcast, which is on the Ascendant Art channel here on YouTube. It's been fun. We usually have a good time ending with music trivia to let everyone have a good change of pace from the normal stuff, you know, that we get talking about on these shows and YouTube. So, and you are the current not reigning champion only because we had a guest and you were being polite. So
I still think I demolished him, but whatever.
Yeah. So that music quiz you did on Friday, I think I got like two of them out of 30. So it's,
I think I got about blur. I think I got about 21 out of the 30.
Anyone who goes to arenas is going to get Song 2 by Blur.
Blur, and I got Foo Fighters, and I recognized the Spice Girls, but I didn't know the song.
I love that the Spice Girls one was recognized by everybody, and they just...
Everybody's like, I'm not saying it.
I don't want to say it, but I know which song this is.
But I love that Jeff got Hanson Mbop off of like two notes.
And then he's like, I did it so I could turn it off the station. I was like, sure you did. Were you the one? No, was it you or Mad who got Creed?
Mad.
Yeah. I was like, you know, Mad was listening to Creed and loving the crap out of it.
He loved it.
I hated Creed. We had to listen to it, but that didn't make me like it at all.
Doesn't make it right.
Yeah. I was pretty happy that I got the Better Than Ezra Desperately Wanting, because that was probably the most obscure song on the list, I think, as far as rock songs.
But I like Better Than Ezra, man.
I still don't think they're better than Ezra. Ezra was great.
No. When Ezra died and they became Better Than Ezra, it was much better.
I do enjoy the fact that their band name was literally like a crapping on someone else.
Yeah, and I think it was literally somebody who died. I think it was either the guitarist or the bass player. I mean, they were called Ezra. One of the band members died. This is at least the urban legend. And then they got somebody else and they got a record deal and named themselves Better Than Ezra because it was better than Ezra.
Couldn't contradict them.
But we didn't, I mean, you didn't even have their most famous song on the list. Desperately Wanting is not their big song.
It was from 97, so they were, that one was,
it was the same album though. They only had the one album that had singles.
It doesn't have to be easy.
But the other one was Wow, It's Been Good, but Living With You, Wow.
I don't know any of these, and I think it's because they were all played in America, not in the UK.
I think you would like Better Than Ezra's at least two songs.
Oh,
and they weren't all American, because Our Lady Peace, which I also got, Superman's Dead, was Canadian.
Yeah, so. I was still living in the UK in the 90s, so for us it was more, at that period, it was more Oasis, Supergrass, Blur, all those bands. Blur were the only one I really got.
All right, so I just looked it up. Good came out in 93 on their album, from their deluxe album, and Friction Baby from 96 had Desperately Wanting. So
I'm shocked that they had a single from apart. Two different albums. That's weird. Yeah. Anyway. All right. I'll go with that. So, as for me, of course, we're back here next Saturday. Doing nothing tomorrow night that I know of. Monday on Comics Division. Tuesday, we've got the gaming stream on my channel. Wednesday, back on Comics Division. And we have a Christian panel on Kerry Smith's show, or Kerry Smith's channel next Wednesday. I'm supposed to be... So, with the revelation that my daughter got married and is having a child... me and X-Ray Girl and Tugs talked about it, and we're taking me from the dad cast where I talk about how to raise your children and be a good dad to the Poor Choices show, because my daughter is now married and having a child.
Wow, that's you're the first one to make the transition. That's congratulations.
Yeah. I'm going from the dad cast to Poor Choices. X-Ray was like, oh yeah, that's definitely we've got to transition that one. But so I'll be like doing that either this Tuesday or the following.
You made the poor choices.
I was going to say, you didn't make the poor choices. And at least you can say, she didn't listen to me. That's
exactly. Well, I mean, she did listen to me in that she got married and then pregnant. She just also hid it for 5 months from all of us. So, no, we're ecstatic that I'm going to be a grandfather in August.
Welcome to the club, old man.
the story has been a funny one. So check that out on the Poor Choices channel either this Tuesday or next Tuesday. We're trying to figure out when we can do it. But yeah, other than that, everybody have a great night. Thank you for being here. Thank you for participating in our bracket challenge and for participating in the Bourbon and Boarding bracket challenge pick'em from chat. And yeah, we will see you next week. Hope everybody's teams, except for, you know,
Two Stars
Winnipeg fans, do well this week. So
indeed.
I think that's it. Anybody got anything else?
Cheerio.
All right, we are out of here. We'll see you next week.
Good night.
Bye. Night, everybody.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah.
Didn't vote on any of the teams. 4-4.